Hey, what's going on, guys? Eric here again, back with another special video for you guys. And it is currently another hot and humid day down here in Louisiana. Still getting hit hard with coronavirus, so they're talking about kind of closing the gyms or maybe even going back to phase one right now. At least that's some of the talk that that I've been hearing at the gym from our firefighters and also our policemen. But anyway, guys, on some better news, as you guys can tell from the title of the video, we're gonna go over a protein powder that you've probably seen in store, and it's gonna be a different type of WheyBolic, and it's called WheyBolic Alpha, okay? WheyBolic Alpha. So WheyBolic Alpha, WheyBolic, you guys know I'm a huge fan of. It has super clean proteins, tons of amino acids, like everything that you need for as far as like a good quality, highly absorbable protein, you know, WheyBolic actually has. And then after that, when you look basically on different sides of the shelf, you're gonna see WheyBolic Alpha, WheyBolic Ripped, all these different types of WheyBolics. So today I'm gonna explain to you what the different kind, this specific different kind of WheyBolic is, and it's gonna be the WheyBolic Alpha today. So I'm gonna go ahead and put the nutrition facts right here for you guys. It's gonna be a pretty raw video from top to bottom. So let's get straight into it. All right, guys, first thing we have is, and we're just gonna base this off of one rounded scoop. In my case, it would be two scoops because I'm a bigger guy. I'm always about getting anywhere between 0.75 all the way up to 1.25 grams of protein in your body, depending on your body fat percentage. But for me, it's two scoops, but I'm just gonna go off the one scoop, and that's gonna be most of the customers and fitness enthusiasts that use this product. So first of all, 100 calories, that's absolutely perfect. That could definitely fit in anybody's diet, anybody's macros. It can basically fit in anybody's diet, especially if you're trying to get protein in and still stay in a caloric deficit. So 100 calories is absolutely perfect. You're only gonna have 10 milligrams as far as cholesterol, guys. So super low cholesterol, only a half a gram of fat, so super low fat. Your protein is 20 grams of protein, which is really good, because if you guys look towards the bottom, you're gonna see that it's actually made out of my two favorite protein types, or two favorite types of whey protein, and that's gonna be whey protein isolate and hydrolyzed whey protein, okay? So hydrolyzed protein and isolate protein are the cleanest types of whey protein that they currently have on the market. So that means that it's actually 90% and above actual real usable protein, and the rest of it is a little bit of milk fat. So super high quality protein, you get a solid 20 grams of it, so it fits industry standards, absolutely perfect. You're gonna have calcium at 100 milligrams, that's good. You're gonna have chromium at 250 micrograms. I'm gonna talk more about chromium later. You have 130 milligrams of sodium, yes. And I know that that may freak people out as far as the sodium content goes, but the truth is, guys, is if you look below that, there's 150 milligrams of potassium. Now, like I said before in previous videos, it's all about that balance of potassium to sodium, okay? So if you have high sodium, but you have enough potassium to balance that out, it's gonna negate the negative side effects that too much sodium has on the body, okay? So the sodium at 130 milligrams, balanced out by the potassium of 150 milligrams, is absolutely perfect. So don't worry about the sodium that's in here, guys. You don't have to worry about the water bloat and all that kind of stuff. The potassium balances out, so definitely check on that one. Now, moving below to the WheyBolic complex, so far everything in here looks really good. You're gonna have branched chain amino acids actually split out for you, so they show you exactly how much leucine, isoleucine, and valine. So those three amino acids, when they come together, they help to cause, especially leucine, causes the mTOR process. So mTOR helps to start what we call protein synthesis, which is basically like a long, complicated name for building new muscle tissue, okay? So not only do you have 20 grams of a really good, solid, like super highly absorbable, clean whey protein, but it's actually reinforced with even more branched chain amino acids to help with more protein synthesis, therefore more muscle recovery and muscle growth. So definitely check in that one. You have glutamine at 3 grams for extra muscle recovery. And then you have two extra things in here, which I really like and probably why I'm the biggest fan of the WheyBolic series. And that's gonna be the mix of velocitol and protease enzymes, okay? So the velocitol and the protease enzymes, basically help your body absorb more of the already highly absorbable protein. So like I said before, you've got whey protein isolate, whey protein hydrolysate, the two of the cleanest proteins they have in the market, okay, for your body that's gonna be able to absorb that. You also have a split up, fully transparent amount of branched chain amino acids and isoleucine, leucine, and valine, but you also have added on to that the velocitol and also the protease enzyme, so your body can actually absorb everything that's in the nutrition labels. So basically, guys, what's the point of having all the good stuff in there if you can't absorb it? Well, that's where the velocitol and the protease enzymes comes in, is it just helps your body absorb everything that's in the nutrition label, and it's already clean and it's pretty awesome too. So definitely a big check and a heavy hitter on that one. Next, moving down to the alpha matrix, which is why they call this the WheyBolic Alpha, you're gonna have creatine. It's gonna be a mix of monohydrate and hydrochloride. So monohydrate, most studied type of creatine they have on the market, obviously that's gonna help with strength and power. You're gonna have creatine hydrochloride mix in there as well, which obviously helps with strength and power. But the hydrochloride is, to me, the better type of creatine because that has way less side effects like water bloat, stomach discomfort, and stuff like that. So creatine in there for the strength and the power. They put beta power, betaine, and hydrous in there, which also helps with strength and power output. So I can see why they put the beta power mixed with the creatine, because those two put together help a lot with more work capacity and more work volume. And then over time with those two, it's gonna lead to more increased muscle size as well. So definitely good on the strength and the power in that one. Next, which is truly the reason why they call it the WheyBolic Alpha, is the testosterone booster, and one of my favorite, if not my favorite type of testosterone booster, Testofen fenugreek. So Testofen fenugreek, guys, is probably one of my favorite and most looked for ingredient when it comes to looking for any type of testosterone booster. It is completely natural, and the way that it actually works is it just basically helps our testosterone from aromatizing over to estrogen. So no, this is not a SARM, it's not steroids, it's not exogenous testosterone entering the body, so it is completely safe. This just helps to manipulate a specific aromatase enzyme in the body to make sure that the testosterone that we do produce, it doesn't roll over and aromatase more into estrogen, so we get to keep more of what we're already producing and reap the benefits from that. So, you know, overall, guys, like, I do like the specs of this nutrition label. I mean, you have a super clean protein that's highly absorbable from the whey protein isolate and the hydrolysate. You have a balanced amount of sodium and potassium. You're gonna have the branched chain amino acids and the leucine, isoleucine, and valine to for reinforced protein synthesis for extra muscle recovery, including the glutamine. You're gonna have the creatine and the betaine anhydrous for that strength and power. And then you're gonna also have the testofen fenugreek, which is really good because it's completely natural and one of the best forms of testosterone, natural testosterone boosting that I know of in the supplement industry. Plus, to round everything off, you have super, super high quality absorption coming from the velocitol and also the protease enzyme. So from the nutrition label, guys, this looks really, really good to me. And there's only one downfall, which I do have to talk about the downfall of the WheyBolic Alpha, and that is just the taste. Okay, so for those of you who have had powdered testosterone boosters before, like they come in a jar and you can just put them in your pre-workout, you could take it by itself, and if you guys know what I'm talking about, like, you drink it and it just tastes super nasty. There is a reason why 95% of testosterone boosters on the market are actually in pill form, so you don't have to taste it. Well, the problem is even though Testofen fenugreek is such an amazing testosterone booster in my personal opinion, and yes, backed by science as well, but the problem with it is that when you taste it, when you drink it, it tastes horrible. It tastes super nasty. It's probably something that I wouldn't even wish upon my own enemy, to be honest. It actually tastes that bad. So normally, guys, like when it comes to a WheyBolic Alpha, And this is why I hate it when they, I love the nutrition label. Like, it literally has everything that I would want in a protein powder. Okay, especially if you're gonna take it post-workout. It's awesome for recovery. The testosterone boosting effect that you would get, you could either take it pre-workout to enhance your training, or you could take it post-workout, because boosting in testosterone is gonna lower the stress hormone cortisol, which breaks down muscle tissue. So lowering that cortisol actually helps to increase more recovery. So like I said, guys, badass nutrition label. But when it comes to the taste, guys, like, it's pretty bad. So in my personal opinion, if you're gonna try out this product, guys, and this is just because I love you guys and I don't want you to go through this pain, definitely make a smoothie out of it. And by that I mean, make sure you throw in a banana, make sure you put like almond milk or whole milk or whatever you can do to make it taste really good, and then go ahead and put the protein in there, make a smoothie out of it, and it's going to taste a whole lot better. Because if you drink this with just water, I promise you, it's going to be the longest 15 seconds of your life drinking this protein. So, and to be honest, guys, when it comes to adherence, you know, your supplement, just like any diet, is only as good as as long as you stick with it. And if this tastes really bad, then you're probably not gonna drink it. So this is my advice, guys, is it's a badass protein for sure. It's a badass protein, super clean, just all the benefits that I just talked about. But because I love you guys, and I'm always trying to tell the, and I'm always telling the truth on here, is definitely make a smoothie out of this. It's gonna taste a whole lot better if you do decide to get the WheyBolic Alpha. So that's my review, guys. That's my personal experience. And I hope you guys are having a wonderful and an awesome 2020. I know that times are super rough right now, and I'm praying for you guys. And just like always, guys, if you have any other questions, just comment below and I'll get back to you as fast as I can. And just like always, don't forget to like, it's probably right there. Don't forget to like, share, and also subscribe right here. Boom. Bye.
And it sounds just like a song. I want your belly and that summer feeling. I don't know if I could ever go without watermelon sugar high.